Saskatchewan, Canada, where you can watch your dog run away for 3 days. Yes, haha, it's so flat and boring here, but I like it. It's a great place to live. This picture here, summer storm. I kind of miss the summer already. It's only mid-October when I'm making this particular recording, but yeah, well, next year. I think summer comes every year, doesn't it? Anyway, in this episode of BackBit Impawsible, I am working on the rollout again. I changed up a little bit. I tested out. I show you, obviously, what I got going on. I start it up and leave you on a cliffhanger. That's it, because I don't want to overstay my welcome here. This episode is long enough. It doesn't help that I talk throughout the beginning part of it, but yeah, it's my video. I can do what I want. Anyway, yeah, so let's get to the clip, shall we?
Just giving it a playthrough. This is the coat that is going to bring in each frame for the rollout code process, which is why it's all chunky. It doesn't matter, because like once a frame is brought in, it's going to take several seconds to process it. But I don't have any of that code in place right now. This is just the raw stuff, and I'm coming up with kind of like a nice little load and save library, kinda. I sorted my code out a bit. I borrowed, from a previous version, and I rearranged the numbers. So now I have kind of like a somewhat generic load routine and a somewhat generic save routine for reading and writing to the BBT. I've always had it, but it's a little more organized now because I want to make this easy for myself. It's kind of cool. I don't know. I mean, it looks like crap right now, but it don't matter, don't matter, don't matter. It's too late. Like, it's almost 1 o'clock in the morning, of course. It's too late to work on this further tonight. I'm just letting it play through while I'm playing PlayStation 2, and just to see how long it takes. And then I can go to bed or something. I'll deal with this tomorrow. But I got some work done on paper. Well, a lot of, scribbles, really, because none of this is going to stick. But you have to get it down on paper. You have to get your ideas down. Otherwise, you can't just sit in front of this thing and dash out some working code. Okay, I changed, stuff. And here's how I did it. The first things it writes directly to three different buffers are color, like the DO21 color, DO22, DO23. It'll set those directly. I'm making use of the last parts of video matrices. You know, they got some spare bytes, right? And after that, we load it with a zero, and then we just write everything that is a zero. And that was it. And then we go to the ones, right? This is the character set stuff all the way up to, and then the five whatevers, that's the video matrix, because you see, that's for the first buffer. I've got 10 different buffers. And these two items have to be in the same video bank. The color is 512 bytes that can be wherever I want. And so after it puts this stuff where it needs to go, it moves on to the one. And as you can see, we're getting closer to the end of a page. Now, I changed how the pages end. See? I fill the entire area with RTSs. So as soon as an instruction, this instruction would not fit here, because this is actually going to be the DF100 page. As soon as it gets to this one and has no more room, it'll execute the RTS. I'm going to let my main program switch the page on the BBT and then probably JSR DF100 to get back in. That way I'm not locked into committing myself to a certain BBT page, by STA DF something something, right? Like it would be 01, at which point it instantly knocks down a track and it's still running from the back bit. In this case, it falls out of the back bit and goes back into my regular code where I can increment X or something, store it DF100, X, and then JSR DF100 to go back inside. At which point this becomes the active page, probably, right? And as that executes, see like LDA 4, 5, 6, 7. And I did some simple calculation. It's going to take about 45 pages no matter what. Same thing happened here. See, there's not enough room for this STA in two RTSs with the RTS included. So it gives up and then moves and forces that next instruction to begin in the next go. And all the way up to, I think, well, at 6,000, things start to get interesting because they're all this 3,000 stuff. This is finally where the color is. And there is a lot here. I forget what value it's setting, but the first go-round, all the color needs to be set no matter what. Oh, yeah, and here's what happens by default when it's filled, absolutely filled up. Just enough room for that, and we continue. Very good code. I like this. So anyway, when it's, well, man, it's going to take a while to get through that. But actually, the color RAM is only 512 bytes, so when we get to 3200, it's going to be done. Almost. There we go. And so actually, most of these were DD writes. I forget what DD is. I guess the high bit is meant for multicolor, of course, and then the other bits are the color or whatever for that square, because it's comparing previous frame to current frame, and I made sure previous frame is all 00000, so everything in the color RAM to B doesn't match, so it makes certain to write all those at the first time around. And then that becomes the old frame, comparing it to the next frame, and most of them will match, at which point we can start getting creative and doing some skipping. But this goes as far as, I forget, but it's 45 pages long, pretty much consistently. Now, there's a little bit of ebb and flow based on how much remainder of a page you have when you hit the RTS, but for the most part, it's going to be 45 pages, and I'm certain of it, so I'm not even going to have to worry about that. What would be 45 pages? I don't even know. Well, EF, okay, so let's say 6D. Okay. 6C. There we go. There, and that's where the end is. After that, there's nothing for 6Ds, 6Es, 6Fs, so... Yeah, we have all the way from 4,000 to the 6C100 page has to get copied to the BBT, and that's what runs later. And then the next frame's activity can follow it exactly 45 pages in, do the next frame. So you can have, well, 45 per and 5 frames. You can fit 5 frames, one exact chunk of 5 frames, 5 buffers, can be filled from one BBT fetch. And it's good. I was just testing what I have. What do we got? 1.01, I think it is. Making sure it's assembled, this puppy. Because, yeah. Well, I had to kill it to bring in the assembler and look at stuff. But anyways, so this should do it. And you see, like, well, I got to do it with the super CPU turned off. But this counts. Like right now, say 90. It's looking for all the 90s, making that list like you saw. It's creating the code. And it's doing it at 1 megahertz because it has to. And once it's done, in this case, 255, it's just going to jump out. But it doesn't have to. Now that I know it kind of works, I'm going to set this thing in motion and put it to work and see what I get. And if it's working, I can move on to the next step. Cool. Thanks for listening to all that. Well, we're doing it. Is it going to work? Is it going to crash? Let's see. Well, let's see both. Come on. Well, whether or not it's saved or not, I have no idea, right? It's going to take a while because if it worked, I have now written over a good chunk of the beginning of my BBT here. And the next frame is going to do the same. 45 pages following it. That's why I made multiple copies of my BBT, because if I fudge this, well, it's already wrecked. And yeah. So I guess I get to do something else now, because I've got 9,000 frames to wait for. Hooray! Okay, I realize this is going to take 2 days to do its thing. So one way to test to see if this is at least writing something, I'm going to hold the stop key here. So when we're back to basic, there, it's all over, right? Okay, so now all I have to do is run it again, because it's going to fetch what it believes is the first frame now, but it's so not going to find it, because I've written it over it with the with my rolled out code. So if this is garbage, we know we got it. And once this frame is complete, we should get different garbage. Nice. And oh, yeah, because it's looking at a video matrix now that doesn't really exist. So nice. Okay. So what's next? What's next? What's next? Okay. Crap. Hey, neat. I wonder what the reason for that is. I don't know. But let me think. I can't think right now. Okay, so this one's fudged, borked beyond belief. I can just start this running on a different BBT now. All right, time to start over. It's funny, because for some reason frame 5 is normal. And so is frame 6. But if I had 39 frames already smooshed into rolled out codeness, you'd think it would have already overwritten frame 5, because like frames 0 and 1 are the first 64K, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Dun, dun, dun. And you only get 5 per, so 5, 10, 15. These frames should have already been overwritten, so something isn't right. I'm going to take one more look at my code, and I also noticed that some of the sprites were changing. Now, these are at the 7400 during what you see, so if a sprite is changing, like it can be changed because it loaded what it thinks is a video matrix and it isn't, but if it's changing, if the sprite shape is modifying itself during the run, that should not happen. Nope, it really shouldn't. And I wonder what's going wrong. So I'm going to have another look at my code before I commit 2 days to this. Yeah, I'm making a mess of things on purpose. I just want to get up a few frames to see if the things that I think might have made a fix have actually fixed it. Because, I mean, I set the write pointer only once before, and I just assumed it was keeping track of it. So when I started sending more bytes, even though in the meantime I've loaded new frames and, you know. So this time I'm keeping track of where I've written to last. And then I'm queuing up like 45 pages in and then writing. And then I just queue up the next frame and I deal with it. And then I queue up the 90 pages in and then do the write. Before, I was just queuing it up once and assuming the BackBit is happily keeping track, when I can't trust it to. So I've got many, many frames in. Yeah, they're all trash. It doesn't matter. So if I run this again, once I get 5 frames in, I shouldn't see 0005, 0006. That should now be a complete mess. We'll see if that's true. Here we go. So I should not get to frame 5, at which point I can stop this test and try again at a regular disabled SuperCPU. Good, I think it's working. Now, I realized why these are changing. Like, it's not that I'm corrupting where my sprites are, because these are sprite pointers. So odds are they're pointing to the 4,000 to 5,000 to 6,000 area just from pure chance. And because of that, That's where data is getting changed, because normally they're at 192 to 199 or something, where I have the digits 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 in a row. But if that is just bogus data, it could be pointing anywhere from 4,000 to 7FFF. So yeah, that makes sense. Anyway, time to power down, try a different BBT, because this first one is now officially wrecked. Plus, I did not show this program last time, which was giving me hints that something was definitely amiss. This basically is looking at the data queued up on the BBT for that first 64K. And as you can tell, this kind of definitely looks like machine code, like SDA something, 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 SDA something, something over and over without a break. Though it should be a small little chunk when the series of RTSs are. I'm not exactly sure when that'll appear. Maybe one of these screens. There it is. Now, it looks like spaces, but I checked that machine code out. That is 96, which is 60 hex, which is an RTS. So yeah, this is truly, I believe, the data it should be now. So I'm definitely on the right path here. I'm just going to wait for this next gap of spaces. There it is. Yep, looking good. Okay. I got enough confidence to start this rolling for reals. And here we are. Fresh reboot. That sucker's off. Hurry up and load so I can assemble you. Come on. And once it's done, this should show me frame zero, and off we go. Good. This is now my second rollout BBT, the one I haven't wrecked yet, which is why I have, you know, sorry, I actually have the frame intact. Okay, let's see. Watch the quick blinks. Do-do-do-do. Come on. Yeah, that took some time. So it saved. Brought in the next frame. I do believe it's finally doing it. So now I have 2 days to let this machine do its thing. We'll see how this goes. Man, I sure hope it works.
Well, I told you it was ending on a cliffhanger. Kinda, you know, obviously in the next episode, I should be done the rollout by then, eh? And, well, what happens next? I guess you'll have to wait and see, because, like before, I'm going to have to wait and see too, because I haven't made that episode yet. I'm not sure what's in it. Maybe just me singing Tom Jones. Probably not.